Hey kids, it's Papa. You ready to explore the Bible? All right. Well, it's Friday morning, and so let's get right into it. Turn with me to Genesis chapter 28. Grab your Bibles, open them up, turn with me to Genesis chapter 28, and let's take a look at Genesis chapter 28. Now, we're going to do something different today. No, we're not. We'll do the same. Well, Jacob, you remember, had to leave home because he had deceived his father. His father had, given him the blessing instead of Esau. Now, Esau was furious, and he said, "I'm going to kill my brother as soon as my dad is dead, and as soon as, you know." And, well, his mother said, "Jacob, you better get out of town, make a run for the border." And so she said, "Go to Ur of the Chaldees, and there you will be taken care of by my family, and so you'd better go." So she sent him on this journey. Well, along the way, it was a long journey. It took many days, and probably a day or two out, he stopped at a place called Bethel. Now, this was a place that was special to Abraham and Isaac. I don't know that he knew that it was special to them, but he stopped there. And that night he decided, "Well, I'm going to go to sleep." And so he had a rock that he used for a pillow. Not very comfortable, huh? But he lay down and he fell asleep. And while he was sleeping, he saw a vision. Take a look with me, if you will, in verse 12 of chapter 28, Genesis chapter 28, verse 12. It says, "And he dreamed, and behold, a ladder set up on the earth, and the top of it reached unto heaven. And behold, the angel of God ascended and descended on it. And behold, the Lord stood above it." And here God talked with Jacob. Now, God had made promises to Abraham, had made promises to Isaac, but he hadn't spoken to Jacob. And here we find that he speaks to Jacob, and he says, "Jacob, I am going to," and then he tells him everything that he had told his grandfather Abraham and his father Isaac, and he said, "I'm going to bless you, and I'm going to make your seed to multiply and be as many as the stars of the sky and the sands on the seashore, and I'm going to bless people that bless you and curse people that curse you, and everybody's going to be blessed because of you," as of course we are, because way on down the line from him was Jesus Christ. And we are blessed by Jesus Christ because of salvation, aren't we? Anyway, so we find that Jacob wakes up, and at first there was some fear. He said, "This is a dreadful place." And he says, "Surely the Lord is in this place." And then he realized this is actually a place of blessing. And so he went and he took that rock that he'd used for a pillow, and he poured oil on it as a sacrifice. And he made a prayer and he said, "You know what? You have been my father's God. You have been my grandfather's God, but now you are going to be my God. And if you will bring me back to my home in safety, if you will give me clothes to wear and food to eat, I will serve you." And I think that's important for us to do, that we need to get to a place where we say, "You know what? You have been my grandfather's God." By the way, that's me. "You have been my father's God." That's your dad. "And now you will be my God." It is important that he not only be God, but that he be my God. You understand that? We need to say, "Lord, I am going to make you the Lord of my life, the God that is the one I'm going to serve." And here we find that Jacob wasn't perfect, and Jacob made a lot of mistakes, and Jacob went on deceiving people and was deceived by other people. But you know what? From this point on, he said, "You are going to be my God." That's important. So remember that. It's not only important that he be God, but it's important that he be my God. My God. And it is important for you that he be your God. So, did you get that? Good. All right. Well, you have a great day, and we hope to see you tomorrow. All righty. Love you guys. See you. Bye-bye.